Mission the Light, October 26, 2018, letter number 66. We live with Christ. Revelations of Jesus Christ through John the Apostle. The ones who believe in Jesus, they live with Him. They live in the heart of Jesus, and Jesus lives in their hearts. These people have been determined to change their old selves, their old person who was sinful. This can happen from one moment to the next. This is something to be done with daily efforts, and it may take years and years to be accomplished. And even then, not without the help of our Lord. The divine virtue supplies constantly with strength and bravery to be able to resist the temptations and the end results of those temptations. Even in our thoughts, without help, we can go forward. Bright example we have that with devotion and heart resistance of the temptations, like Apostle Paul did. Paul, he believed so much in the Lord, he submitted to the Lord totally, and he received the promises of God who are written in the Scriptures. 2 Corinthians 12, verses 2 through 6. I know a man in union with Christ who, 14 years ago, whether in the body, I do not know, or out of the body, I do not know, God knows, was cut away, as such, to the third heaven. Yes, I know such a man, whether in the body or apart from the body, I do not know, God knows, that he was cut away into paradise, and heard an unspoken words which is not lawful for a man to speak. Over such a man I will boast, like I will not boast over myself, except as respects my weaknesses. For if I ever do what to boast, I shall not be unreasonable, for I shall say the truth. But I abstain in order that no one shall put to my credit more than what he sees I am or he hurts from me. From the time Paul met the Lord, he wanted only what the Lord wanted for his children. Paul had found Christ. He had found the most precious jewel of heaven and earth. Paul didn't mimic the Lord by following the heavenly, but by following the heavenly orders, he met the Lord. He knew him, he united with him. And yet something more than that happened. Christ himself lived with Paul. He led him in all his actions. Paul didn't belong to himself anymore. He felt in his core, he lived it in each minute and allowed it freely himself to be in a great trust and love into the hands of Christ. This makes Christ our Lord and Father so happy. Yet the truth of the matter is, Paul found himself, the self that was rebirthed through Christ. Our Lord Christ had spoken about this marvelous event to his disciples while lived with them. He had told them, when someone loves him truly, then God will love him also. He will live inside that person. John 14, verse 23. Jesus answered and said unto him, If a man loves me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him, and we will come into him and make our abode with him. The ones who live in love and freedom, God speaks to them and he listens to them. The voice of God is clear in his soul and in his spirit. That person can clearly understand that is happening for real. God does live inside of us. We are the little beings who live with God. He allows us and we are welcome. As long as we believe in Him, the rest comes on its own. The Lord constantly helps us to climb the heavenly ladder toward Him. He blesses us with his holy virtues of the Holy Spirit because Father God knows the depths of our hearts. He knows the true feelings of love and devotion we have for him. Our Father is caring for all the beautiful things we feel for him. He comes close to us with his fatherly love each moment of our lives. He stretches his hand to us always. Perhaps in the beginning, we go slow with small steps toward him like a shy child, mesmerized by the fact that this is true, that all these are not just promised words in the scriptures, but it's a real promise in all its depth. We are talking so much strength and bravery, and our little steps toward him now it's more comfortable and assured that he wanted to go to him, that we wanted to go to him. He always waiting for us with a great longing to hug us tight, to feel fully his perfect fatherly hug. Brothers, is worthy to try to be better beings, is worthy to make our Father in heaven happy and joyful because we act according to his will. May we try until the end of our lives to do God's will. May we follow his orders. Yes, we live in the world that so many traps, they are visible and invisible. The temptations, the bad thoughts, it's against us. Problems and more problems are jumping from everywhere in our lives. There are myriads of ways that we are suffering, but even so, my brothers, is worthy to try. The Lord knows all the sufferings that we are facing. He is showing compassion. He understands us. He is not a cold-hearted God. Even our smallest effort, he makes it to an account. He knows we love him and we respect him totally, and that's why he will never abandon us. He bends with so much love toward us. He is not careless, nor he is sitting in a mighty throne far away from us, nor he have great expectations. He is happy when we try with all our strength. He is happy, and also he is awarding us for that. He does send his virtues on us, protecting us with his light. He leads us and guides us. The Lord is calling us to leave any unpleasant mistake and sins behind us, to look forward in his bright path. He is the illuminating lighthouse that we can see no matter where we stand in our lives. With his light, we will find the path that leads to everlasting life and his mighty arms. Hallelujah. Amen.